Squarespace vertical timelines. Let's dig into an empty new Squarespace site, and I'm going to show you the basic idea on how you can use a code block, a little bit of CSS, and start sketching a timeline using the Squarespace 7.1 fluid engine. So first I'm going to mention I have a plugin that I have designed coming soon, probably released when you look at this video. It's also it actually has two different versions, one similar to what we will show in this little tutorial, but also another perhaps even more advanced one using the portfolio pages. So you can also find my blog post about Squarespace vertical timelines, the products, versions of my products, and all that. But without further ado, let's jump into this. I haven't prepared other than I know how to create these timelines. So it's gonna be an experiment. I think it's gonna be fun. So let's start with a blank section, okay? So first what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a code block. Okay, and I'm gonna put it here in the center, and here I'm gonna add a div, and I'm gonna add a class of vertical timeline. Okay, cool. Now we have a vertical timeline here. So I'm gonna put it, I'm gonna drag it to be a little bit higher, and maybe we'll do it like this. Then I'm also, I'm just gonna add a code block, sorry, text block here. I'm gonna add a heading. I'm gonna use the level 4 heading, and I'm gonna add some dummy content and a read more. Cool. Okay, so how do we actually make a vertical line, a timeline base? Well, let's save and exit, go to design and custom CSS. Here I'm gonna paste the vertical timeline, and I'm just gonna add a height of 100 pixels just for now. Background is gonna be black. Width is gonna be 1 pixel, and margin is gonna be auto. So it's gonna be beautifully in the center. Okay. So actually what we would like to happen is we would like to not have a fixed width. And this is kind of one of the cool things about my plugin, is that you're able to stretch this. So now if we try and edit this, you kind of see that, you know, it's not working like we should. So I'm gonna use these very kind of latest Squarespace, well, not Squarespace, but CSS properties, only supported in the modern browser. So keep that in mind. My plugin, sorry to always bring it back to it, but my plugin has a extra JavaScript that makes it work for older browsers as well. But this will kind of demonstrate the basic idea. So I'm gonna go for SQS block content. So that's the parent for the timeline div. Okay, has, and I'm gonna add this here, and I'm gonna add a height of 100%. Okay, so let's see if we turn this now into 100%. Beautiful. So let me explain what this is doing. So now the Squarespace block inside a code block, there are a few kind of inner elements. By default, the height is 0. So without this one, the height is 100% of 0 pixels. So if we make the height be 30 pixels, it's going to be 100% of 30 pixels. But if we make the height of this parent element be 100%, well, then now we are in business. So if we hit save, so what we can do now is we can drag that to be higher, and now it's going to be higher. So a lot of things that I've had to work for my plugin, for example, it kind of disappears until you exit. In my plugin, all of those are fixed, but this will get you the general idea. Okay, so maybe we'll drag this a little bit further. I would like to see if maybe we can add like a timeline stop here. This is going to be very kind of free form, so I'm just winging this as I go. Let's see. So could we do something like that? Could this work? Okay, it's not fitting perfectly, so let's see. We can come up with a solution for that. Yes, okay, oh, sorry about that. So one of the things you probably want to do if you're playing with the lines and you want them to align with each other is to get rid of the gap in the grid. So as you can see, now that there is no gap, these start to align a lot better. Okay. Okay, let's add a little bit more height to it. I'm so used to seeing the timeline because that's how my plugin does it, but it's pretty advanced code. Let's see if I can add it also, but first let's add this to the different side. Let's have a one kind of row of space between these. All right, this is starting to look like a timeline. So very much similar to what I do with my plugin. Once you have these basic elements, you're just gonna be able to duplicate them. You can grab like both of them and you can drag both of them at the same time. Right. So this is the basic idea of kind of a very simple minimalist way to have a beautiful timeline. You're of course able to add the date if it's an actual like a timeline with dates. For that one, I recommend the monospace. So maybe we have like January 2, 2023, or maybe 2nd of January. Not sure how the formats go for international audiences. In Finland, we have kind of a different type, but let's just go with something like this. I'm gonna align this here as well. And cool, so now we are styling these elements. Maybe we want a font size of maybe 13 pixels. Override something. Okay, I'm gonna add a little bit of letter spacing 0.05 mm. Bit too much, maybe two, something like that. It's still looking a little bit too big for my taste. Could it be even smaller? Yeah, maybe. Okay, so I'm now creating a lot of the elements from my plugin. So how about we edit a little bit of the spacings and then we call this tutorial done. You will have the basic idea. Margin zero, important. Okay. I would like to get rid of this. Extra space here. Okay, specifying these elements. These code pre-elements are a little bit weird. How's that? I think that's looking pretty nice. All right, so this will get you a pretty, a rough idea on how to go about this. Of course, you need to design the mobile view, which is gonna be just dragging the elements. Cool, so if you're adventurous, go for it. If you're a lazy person and you wanna get the best of the best, I've spent a lot of time on this, then this is gonna handle all those little quirks automatically, support all the browsers. It's gonna have animations, it's gonna align perfectly, it's gonna have the timeline will be visible at all times. You can align it to the left, to the right. It's gonna have prettier kind of these timeline stops. It's gonna handle things like when you get to the mobile view, it's gonna align these right align text to the left on mobile with this kind of custom smart CSS, and it's gonna do all kinds of things. But if you're adventurous, then hopefully this tutorial gave you kind of a starting point on how you can go about building your own version of the vertical timeline. All right, so cool. Thanks so much for watching, and let me know any thoughts on timelines. Cheers.